Hello, friends. Friend. I'm gonna do some Final Fantasy today. So I'm gonna just get right into that as soon as I can. What's up, Nate? Okay. So. Off we go to quest. Stones, we go. Pondering dinner. Okay. Tataru, what have you got for me? Tataru is putting on a pot of tea and looks in need of company. Namina, how lovely to see you. If you're not in too much of a rush, I was about to make a pot of tea. Would you like a cup? Sure. I'll drink your stink tea. Take a seat then, and I'll find us something to nibble on as well. Okay.
It's so much quieter these days without everyone around. Not that I'm pining for your return, you understand. I have my sources, and I know that each and every one of you is doing well and keeping busy with your endeavors.
Hey, Princess Boy.
Meanwhile, I'm left with a surplus of free time and the question of how to make the most of it. What about you? Any plans for the immediate future?
I'm still mulling it over. God, I'm pretty.
I hope you weren't thinking of asking me for advice. Though if you are open to suggestions, I might have one for you.
God, she is.
You fought bravely and selflessly, helping those in need and saving our star from unimaginable threats.
Yeah, that's what I do.
For your deeds, you've been hailed as the champion of Eorzea and a host of other incredible things.
Yeah,
but
I'm just awesome.
Why not put those titles aside for a while?
Woo! It's Friday!
Put yourself as a simple adventurer again and travel the world in search of wonder.
Okay, what should I say, you guys? You're right. Who knows what mysteries are still waiting to be discovered? Or, that's a great idea, but where to start? I'll be assertive. Man, I'm pretty.
Oh, that's the spirit. I can feel from here the blazing fire that just lit in your belly.
Are you feeling my belly?
Now. All you need is a destination.
The enigmatic silence. Deciding,
just leave it to me.
There's a cat in my way.
Thavnir. That's where you should go next.
Hell yeah! We're going to Thavnir, bitches!
I doubt you were able to squeeze in a proper tour of Rhazatarn the last time you were there. What with the burning skies and rampaging monsters and so forth, and I'm sure Ritra would be pleased to see you. Then there's the bounty itself. The Empire's presence in the region was always a deterrent to exploration. So if you've a mind to sail that sea, now's your chance.
Are you sending me to Thavnir or not?
The experiences you could have.
Have you been to the ruins beneath the waters of the bounty? As the bearer of Azen's crystal, you may consider your duty to see at least that much.
Oh, I know that look. That's an adventurer ready to take on the world.
Yes!
In anticipation of an occasion like this, I was planning to gift you a new set of traveling clothes, but it's still a work in progress.
He's not Sephiroth.
Shouldn't take much longer now, though, so sit tight and I'll have the last few bits sewn up before you can finish another cup of tea.
Ooh, do I get another outfit? I get another outfit! Make sure it has pockets! Yeah! Oh gosh. The moose is here.
Stitching here and trimming there. Knot the threads with love and care.
When did we fall into a J.R.R. Tolkien book?
Just a little more to go. I'm sure you're still brimming with excitement. I won with the needle. See how the fabric surrenders to my whims.
Okay, while we're watching Tataru sew my outfit, I guess.
Don't worry. Let's
sure treat
the
some kitties.
Has plenty of pockets for all your little treasures. I swear, adventurers are worse than children.
Oh my god, get off
Oh
god, get off my keyboard! Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Chaos!
We mustn't forget the waterproofing. Gods forbid you forget to disrobe before plunging into the sea or a river.
Okay.
A piping hot bath.
Oh my god, okay. What is this? Guys, what's...
Unless I am returned.
No. Formal protest? I'm concerned. I fell asleep.
Ah, you're awake.
You let me sleep sitting up? In armor?
My apologies. I do get a little carried away with my sewing. You seem awfully cheerful. Pleasant dream? Or are you just looking forward to the next chapter of your grand saga? Either way, I promise to provide you with new apparel, and so I shall. If you'll accompany me to the Diamond Forge, we can put the finishing touches on your outfit.
The Diamond Forge? Okay. That... It's, I have a concern. The Diamond Forge. All right. What's up, Tataru? Observe as the artiste refines her piece into a masterpiece. And no napping this time. I only need a moment. You'll see. Fade to black means I've fallen asleep. All done. Let's see how it looks on the mannequin. Well, it says something, all right. Yes, politely clap. I'm so glad you approve. I didn't say I approve. So what do I owe you for this atrocity? Don't be silly, your approval is payment enough. If you really want to thank me, though, all I ask is that you wear this on your travels. Or at least anywhere lots of adventurers might gather. Hehe. They'll look at you, a famous hero, and wonder where did they get those stylish yet practical garments. And before you know it, hordes of new customers will be climbing over each other to place an order at Tataru Daru's boutique. Sure. God, she's a goblin! Alright. Hello, Hiccup. Up, I need to read. Burgeoning merchant empires aside, you must be excited to start a fresh chapter of your life. New places to go, new people to meet. I often wonder how you remember. Thanks. Maybe you should start doing just that. You never know when some odd past detail might become relevant, or if one day you'll take a blow to the head and forget the better part of the past decade. Something to keep in mind, in any case. Well... Collection expanded! The Unending Codex! What? This is cool! I'm not gonna read this shit, but this is cool! Okay. Okay. Bountiful ruins. I'll unend your codex. Hiccup, you are really making it difficult for me to read things. I just want you to know that. He's just sitting in front of my monitor. There. Okay. Oh, let me check my... Hiccup, what are you doing? Mm-hmm. you're gonna go somewhere. Okay, so we have to go to Razapan. I love Razapan. I really do. It's one of my favorite places ever. Oh, Astidian's gone. No, I wanted to see Astidian. Damn it! Ugh. Welcome to Marriott's Mayhan. Oh, hello. I did not recognize you at first. Are you here alone? Let me find you a table. I'm actually looking for an elf. Ruins beneath the bounty. Would you be speaking to the sunken treasure vault? We have one regular, a historian, in fact, who could tell you all about it. Bitch, they got dancers! There he is, Professor Jaleen. I thought I saw him come in. Though somewhat a private sort, the professor is quick to befriend those who share his fondness for Mayhan's unique beverages. Offer him any drink from our selection and he should happily share everything he knows about the vault you seek, and a few other odd bits besides. He's gonna show me his bits? Jaleen! Yes? Following event cannot be skipped. You may wish to cancel any pending Duty Finder registrations. Yes! I would like to begin speaking with this man. He'll show you only if you get him drunk. Yeah, it's true. And what may I do for you, my Eorzean friend? Oh, just a friendly chat. How about a drink? Hell, so wouldn't say no to a drink freely offered. Boom! Bottoms up. Chug, 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 chug. He empties the cup in a single pull. He is a fucking drunk. That was very kind of you, miss, but I know when I'm being softened up. What is it that you want from me? Oh, chasing down that old tail, are you? Right? He is. Yeah. My auto mod is weird. He was Khan of the Auri tribe. His decision to aid the Araxadora is what ultimately won them the war against the Gajasura, thus allowing our predecessors to lay the foundations. Truly fascinating stories, however, concern his grandson, Alzadal III, who was known for his deeds as a satrap. What's up, Walter? Some attest this man has traveled to another world entirely and returned with glittering riches. Then there's the tale of the sunken vault, the one you seem most curious about. According to the legend, he claimed a small island somewhere in the middle of the bounty. With hair, he built a structure reaching to clear the bottom of the sea. Deep in secret storehouse, where he locked all his worthy wealth within. Fan theories! What's your fan theory? This bitch. Another round for the professor. This motherfucker is drinking me out of house and home. Ah, I see we've reached an understanding. You're a sharp one. Look, I just know when to get someone fucking drunk. Another for the professor. Oh, today was a splendid day to visit the man. Those who did return from seeking the treasure vault refused. I mean, flatly refused to speak of what they saw. This dude is fucking trashed. Did this discourage others? No, quite the opposite. Such strong accounts only served to feed the legend, and the golden lure grew stronger than ever. That reminds me of something Azama was saying. Azama's a fellow connoisseur of spiritus potables. Yes, he is. Anyway, he was saying that one of his acquaintances went after the treasure himself. Hasn't been seen since he set sail, I hear, but he did have a... Oh, I can say no more. You seem a generous sort, and what kind of man would I be to encourage what is clearly a foolhardy quest? If my word sent you to your death, I could never live with myself. I am no stranger to peril, sir. Right? I need to do that, huh? Is that so? Perhaps soon it's your turn to tell a tale. Okay. The very edge of existence. From anyone else, I'd struggle to believe it, but I recognize you now. You're the hero of the final days. A drink. I need another drink to settle my nerves. More of the same, please. I need to add the shots sound alert now. Okay. He's a fucking lightweight unless those drinks are really fucking potent. Three drinks and he's this bad? You being who you are, I suppose it wouldn't hurt him to share a little more. This friend was desperate to buy a treasure map. Seems he could only get it from some merchant. What's his name? I forget. Let's drink a toast to you, my new best friend. More drinks! Old man metabolism. Signaling for water. Winky winky! You drink, sir. Your drink, sir. Marvelous, I'm parched! That was water! Did you tell her to bring me water? Still, that's probably for the best. Very kind of you. My head will certainly thank you in the morning. I seem to have overindulged. I am to put to minds of the word. Be wary of how much drink you swallow, lest it swallow you. Dude! I wish you fortune in finding your fortune. What's up? Waltop.
GG!
Oh. The Ken from Street Fighter looking rough. Oh no. That's okay. Thank you for the posture check and the stretch. That was good. I am Azama, and who might you be? Your worst nightmare. All true, I'm afraid. My friend took a ship out in search of Alzadal's legacy, and I've been watching for his sails ever since. tried to dissuade him, of course, but he refused
to
listen. Oh! I'm Taco Panda! What's up, my friend? All he could talk about was finding that vault. And that look in his eyes, I knew it wasn't common gold or jewels he lusted after. He was hunting the otherworldly horde, and his ambition would not be denied. I got another worldly horde for you. Right here. I see that in you too. That appetite for the mysterious and the unknown.
It's a sexual appetite.
I'll not attempt to turn you from your path. I know too well the futility of that endeavor. That's very sweet of you. So I will tell you that what my friend told me. He convinced a merchant in the bazaar to give him the rough location of the vault's entrance. Seems that this merchant is selling a map which shows the exact route, but my friend's purse was too light for its exorbitant price. With what meager wealth he had, he instead paid to learn that there are ruins on the small island somewhere in the bounty, and within those ruins hides the path to the vault deep below. If you truly intend on seeking this treasure, I suggest you put your affairs in order. I wish things were different, but I do not believe my friend is ever coming home. Okay, but you're talking to the warrior of fucking light here, so... put that in your pipe and smoke it.
Please, Ashal, please! You must let me have that treasure map!
What's all this about?
My mother and father were slaughtered by monsters. My baby sister, still too young to fend for herself. Can you spare us no kindness?
What's up, Deathbrook?
So, you hope to find your fortune? And what? You expect me to surrender my wares for pity's sake?
That's bad business.
What are you to offer in payment? As I thought, come back when you've more than rags to your name. This is no mere treasure map. It is a guide to the vaults of Arzadal III, one of the great satraps of Razat-Har, and a direct descendant of Alzadal Khan.
Hair jiggle physics, yeah.
A map to Alzadal's legacy.
So he says. A fake, I'd wager.
This is no fake. The parchment is marked with an arcane glyph of passage. You may find the ruins hidden in the bounty, but you won't be setting foot inside without this in your possession.
You're gonna give it to me.
The artifact is discovered amongst the rubble in the aftermath of the final days, and lovingly restored by yours truly.
I'm gonna punch you in the face and get it.
This map is the key to fabulous riches, and I'll be the king of fools to simply give it away.
Anime
be glad
spike.
I am no such king, boy. Your scrawny eye did never return with that treasure alive.
Why must you tempt me with wealth I am powerless to claim?
This is a little
How
much.
I shall envy the one who purchases that precious map. Whatever they pay will be but pittance against the golden hoards they stand to uncover.
This is a trick. This is a trick. Estinian! My baby! Hello, darling! Oh, God.
What of you, sir? Fighting man of your stature would surely relish the challenge of recovering Alzadal's lost fortune.
Oh god, Ascidian, please don't do this. You are bad with money.
A fortune, you say?
If I had but the strength to seize that treasure, my starving sister would never want for food.
Estinian baby.
I'll take it. Will this cover the price?
Oh, Estinian. Honey, haggle! Honey! You have to learn to haggle in Razadan! Okay, so it's your dick I'm sucking to get that map, then.
Well,
hi, Matt, baby.
My friend.
Hey, baby, what's up?
Someone is dressed for adventure.
Yeah, baby. In bed.
Why Favner, of all places? Knowing you, I suspect there's more to your plans than sightseeing and shopping.
Oh, you know it.
Ruins beneath the bounty. Curious. And here I've acquired a map to just such a site.
How convenient!
With that sale, I do believe I've earned the rest of the day off. Thank you for your patronage, sir, but if you'll excuse me.
You needn't mind us.
Hey! Fuck you, his bangs are fine. His bangs are perfect.
And
they are
the heroes of the final days. Pray the sisters were looking elsewhere.
And now I've fleeced the... Oh, bitch. I knew it was going to be that way.
Either way, we'll need a ship to find out for sure.
Okay. Never took you for a treasure hunter.
Lest you misunderstand, I seek the treasure not for myself. If such a fortune truly exists, then it could help ease the struggles of those who lost their loved ones.
Oh, he's so
days.
Generous. My love is so generous.
For Favnir, what you and Alphino did for the Alamegans when you recovered the Mad King's trove.
Yeah.
Come now. You know Alphino needs little encouragement when it comes to recounting the tales of your shared exploits.
How? You can't be any more perfect. I mean, you can be better with money, but... What?
Speaking of precocious lads, that boy in the bazaar was clearly an accomplice of the merchant. Suppose his role was to draw the attention of the crowd and add weight to the merchant's bold claims. Transparent act for the most part. It was not all mummery. The need to provide for his sister rang true enough.
Did you aura perceive him?
Some portion of the profits end up in that waif's pockets, then I will consider it money well spent. Whether the map leads us to the vault or not. You are coming along.
Oh, I will be coming. Naturally. With you, Estinian?
I thought as much.
Always.
Now, let's see about securing a vessel.
I'll secure your vessel. Between my thighs. Two dragoons go off on an adventure together. being harassed by a cat. Hiccup. Oh my goodness. Prepare to be boarded. Oh! You will recall I spoke of visiting Thavnir at Vitra's request. Well, he finally invited me to a feast. And made his proposal once I was too full of Hunnish delights to refuse. He wishes me to train the Radiant Host in lance work. Oh, show me how you handle that lance, baby. That is a tale for another time. What we need now, is a merchant or a trawler with a ship fit for the open seas. Matsya is a fisherman by trade, yes? We should head to Akyali and see if he can help us. Alright. That's fine. Sorry about the delays in my narration, but I have this cat, you see, who keeps pacing in front of my fucking monitor. I can't read. You. This moose. I do know literally the world's greatest airship builder. Just soak in the vibes. I think Hiccup likes being held. Okay, here we go. Now we have to go to Akyali. Let's go to Yedlamad. And then we'll go from there. I'm on my Midgard Sormer. Okay. Hiccup. Bro. This is a face that only a mother could love. So big. Ugh, cat. Okay, so we are heading over to Akyali, which is over this way. Thank you. pick up... Bro. Where do you knock over my mascara? I have cat hair in my mouth! Dude, come on! This cat is driving me nuts. I need to... send him away. Pick up my dude. Come on. Alright, let's go see what we got going on over here. Estinian, my love! I'm hoping to hire a ship rather than buy one. My funds would not stretch that far. I'm flexible. I got 15 million gil. My friends, what brings you to our humble village? We're looking for a boat. Considering it was your deeds which allowed us to return to fishing, I should think everyone would be glad to repay the favor. Have you noticed our little shadow? He's been following us since we left the city. We see you there, boy. Show yourself. it is you. Do you know how far out of our way we walked so that you'd not cross paths with some wild beast? Aren't you the heroes who saved Thadnir? You are, I know you are. And I've gone and cheated you. I work with him, you see, the map merchant. It's my job to pay the pleading orphan and convince the crowd his wares are worth the price he asks. I'm ashamed of what I've done, and I beg for your forgiveness. If not for you, my sister and I would never have... Well, we'd be... Aww. I knew your game, and I paid the price willingly. A fortunate purchase, as it turns out, for my friend here was seeking those very rooms. Kind to overlook the wrong I have done you, but there is more you need to know. Okay, so tell me. Yeah, daddy. The map you bought is very real, as the island it shows, but I overheard him selling information to the other customers. He told the man that where he needed to search, about the ruins, about the vault, about everything. The man sailed out to find his fortune, never to return. You cannot go alone to that place. You should have more friends with you. Maybe even a whole army. I do not doubt the ruins hold danger, but I assure you, between the two of us, there is little we cannot overcome. I cannot bear the thought of... I'm gonna tease Astinian. Now you've gone and made him cry. I did not. That was not my intention. Very well. Assuming we do find this treasure hoard, it may prove wise to have more hands along for the carrying. Any ideas on whom to approach? The scions have scattered far and wide since our last gathering. I must insist on my dear dads. Thancred and Oriange. Those two would answer our call, certainly, but they left the Rising Stones with a definite task in mind, and I am loath to interrupt their self-appointed mission. Fine. Now, if you know an Alice. Were they not bound for Garlemald? They have far more important matters to attend to than delving for trinkets. Graha and Kryle. Aye, Kryle may have her hands full with rebuilding the students, but if you reach out to Graha, surely he would leap at the invitation. That sets your mind at ease. Yes, if that man is as strong as you. Is he, though? Strong, I mean? Well, I mean, what is your name, boy? What is your name, boy? Merad. Well, your life is yours to live as you will. But wait, boy. I didn't take this roundabout road just to see you end up in some creature's belly. Let me walk you back to the city gates.
Thank you, sir.
Call me Astidian. I'll call you Daddy. Alright, hiccup. No. No. She'll leave you to recruit Graha. He'll appreciate the invitation that much more, I'm sure. Yeah, because he's thirsty for me. He was based in the annex. Someone there might ought to be able to point you in the right direction. Do me a favor and don't stray too far. I'm gonna be really lazy about it. And just run to the. Just port to the annex. Hello? Oh, look who it is. Welcome back. What can we do for you? Give me my cat boy. Oh, he's in the main hall with Mrs. Kryle. They've been holed up in there for days. By all means, go and give them an excuse to take a break. Graha, baby! I've come to claim you!
Ah, Urgica, my good man.
No?
Would you be so kind as to...
Sorry, it's your dream girl.
Oh, isn't this a pleasant surprise?
I wish you had sent word ahead. I thought I was having visions for a moment there.
Oh, he's so cute. He dreams about me. What are you working on?
Raha and I have been compiling old records of the students' activities. We located several accounts in the archives of Numenon, and added them to the collection we recovered from the Isle of Val.
And judging by the progress we've made thus far, sorting this pile will keep us occupied for days to come.
Woo!
But what brings you to the annex, my friend? Surely you haven't come all this way just to watch us shuffle dusty papers around?
I need a tank!
That is the issue. Is that I need a tank.
The treasure vault of Alzadar the Third.
Woo!
And yeah, you're looking for companions to join you on this expedition.
I sure am!
I would dearly love to accompany you, of course. But I'm afraid I'm committed to another task.
You're also not part of the trust system.
On the subject of which, I had hoped to ask for your assistance.
Let me get the treasure first and I'll help you. His ears are wiggling!
Then again, it's not so urgent that it can't wait until you've returned. You should go, Raha. I'll stay here and mind the shop, as it were.
Are you sure? I'd hate to leave you short-handed.
I'm sure. Just try to be back before too many moons have passed.
Well, I guess we're off on another adventure already.
You bet, baby.
Have you asked anyone else to come along?
I need to know.
Then might I suggest we invite your Stola?
Sure.
Ever since the Scions disbanded, she's spent most of her time cloistered within the great Google library, hoping to piece together a method to traverse the rift. It would seem, however, that whatever wisdom she sought there was not to be found. She arrived in Charlion the other day. We spoke briefly before she began her search of Numenor.
Aww.
Considering what you've told us of Alzadal's extraordinary feats, I do believe your Stola would be more than interested to hear what you have to say. Splendid! Then let us head to the archives at once.
Wait, before you go. I have another potential member to volunteer, if you've room to spare. Urianger.
Oh?
He sent the students a request for materials, you see. Treatises on the architecture of treasure vaults and the like.
Oh, God.
From what I can gather, the Loperites are looking to make improvements to their own creation and wish to learn more about how we build things down here.
Oh.
So, why not take Urianger with you? Let him study Alzadar's legacy firsthand.
That makes sense for Urianger. That's why I wanted to take him!
None can deny the benefit of seeing something with your own eyes. If our expedition leader has no objections, I say we extend Urianger an invitation once we've spoken with your Stola.
Safe travels, you two. But don't forget, I'd still like your help with that other matter I mentioned.
Right. Then it's off to the library.
Has been added to the Unending Codex. Cool. Where am I going? Where's Stola? Stola is that way, so. Oh, Lord. Alright. We're just gonna run. Oh, excuse me! Are you guys having fun? I'm having fun. I haven't actually been doing the MSQ because I've been waiting to do it on stream. Oshtola! Oshtola! Oh my god. I'm sorry, hang on. I need to see this. She is passed out in a pile of books. I have never related so hard to another character in my entire life. Fucking hashtag me too. Stola. I need to gently wake her up because otherwise she'll set me on fire. Oh, she's so cute.
I've never known Yshtola to doze off in the middle of research before.
She'll light you up. We'll just wait until she wakes up on her own, because if she's cranky. Mistress. We didn't want to wake you. 'Cause you will burn us.
Nor did I want to fall asleep.
Yes, but you needed it.
I must have been studying for 2-3 days straight before exhaustion finally claimed me. As you know, I've been researching ways to travel from the source to one of its reflections. Well, looking for hints at least. I don't expect to find a simple set of instructions tucked away in some dark corner of the library. So I've been skimming through the stacks, hoping to uncover even a partial mention of any similar feats in the past.
Mm-hmm.
A means to travel between worlds exists, and you can be sure I will find a way to employ it. So I've promised Runa, but 'twould seem I've set myself a nigh impossible task.
Aww.
You needn't be so hard on yourself. The leap I made with the Crystal Tower was not achieved in an afternoon. It was the culmination of a collective effort spanning generations.
Oh, you think me discouraged? I assure you, it is quite the opposite.
And no, now I'm just mad.
And the time to sink my teeth into it. I feel like a fresh-faced student again.
Oh, Jesus.
A scholar in her element.
Indeed. Was there something else you wished to ask of me?
Yeah, you want to go treasure hunting?
Elzadal is no minor figure in Harnish history, and much is known about his family. But this is the first I've heard of a descendant surviving a trip to another world. If those tales are true, then he may have left behind some clue as to how it was accomplished.
Okay, that's fair.
An invitation to delve into one of the world's lingering mysteries. As if I could refuse. And whence do we embark upon this expedition?
Now?
Akiali, by ship. But before that, we thought to extend an invitation to Urianje as well. He was in Thaumazane, last we heard.
Then by all means, let us recruit him and be on our way.
I get to go see my other elf dad. Okay. I don't remember where Thaumazane is. Oh, okay. Oh, crap, I'm in water. Okay. I will get to these side quests that I've got, like, laying around when I get my, when I get to starting my leveling of other classes. Hello, Claire Lane. Yes. Take me down! Bitch. Also, just as an FYI, if you guys are part of my spicy lads of Patreon, you will have access very, very soon to Hump Day Simming, and just think about what that means. Yeah. If you don't want to be a spicy lad, that's fine. You can just, if you do just $1 a month, you can have access to my blog, my sketchbook, and whatever other random shit that I decide to, like, display on Patreon.
Ah, our illustrious champion.
Hi, baby.
Cloaked in the mantle of the common explorer, fame set aside in thy pursuit of simple adventure.
Yes.
I am told a new expedition is in the offing.
Wasn't Thancred with you?
He left to attend to some personal errand, but should be returning ere long.
Personal errand meaning a bitch to fuck.
You've been keeping yourself busy, I trust?
True to our plan, Thancred and I embarked upon a pilgrimage of sorts, with an eye for gauging the state of those lands through which we passed. Our travels were interrupted, however, by a request for aid from our befurred lunar allies.
The Lopperets.
The Lopperets have been seeking new purpose for the moon, another role through which it might serve to benefit mankind. The Forum have been working to advise them in this endeavor, but I return to offer mine own counsel.
And
oh, yeah.
This has what to do with treasure vaults, exactly?
Lorianje has chosen better robes.
You have learned of my predicament from Mistress Crime. I know not whence they acquired such knowledge, but the Lopperets now stand convinced that adventurers delight in treasure hunts.
We sure do!
Thus, with their newly built wonderland of riches and mystery, do they hope to entice all manner of daring delvers to the moon? So earnest and innocent was their desire to bring joy to the world, that I found myself powerless to refuse them my cooperation. But what of you, my friends? Why are you come to Labyrinthos?
We need a healer.
Fascinating. This is indeed a most fortuitous opportunity.
Yeah, baby. Fortuitous in my pants.
I should be honored to accept thine invitation.
Yeah. I invite you to my pants. Yes.
How long has it been, I wonder, when last our actions were not impelled by fate or desperation?
I mean, true.
Aye. Though I cherish the Scion's accomplishments, 'tis pleasant to not have the weight of the world upon our shoulders for a change.
But, that's gonna change.
Counting Justinian, we number 5 now, yes? Without knowing what traps or perils await unwary feet, we may be wise to refrain from recruiting others.
I agree. Between us, we should have the skills to handle whatever situation may arise. Shall we be on our way?
I got a situation arising in my pants.
What, no time to spare a word for the grizzled old bard?
Ah! Hey, baby!
All is well, I trust.
A wasted trip, I'm afraid. I'd hoped to catch up with a former mentor while you parleyed with the rabbits, but it seems our paths were not to cross.
How was your pilgrimage?
Having an astrologian beside you on the road is surprisingly convenient. And it doesn't hurt that he's making strides with his light-hearted banter.
Oh, that's cute. Nope, don't see yourself out, Walter. You are welcome here.
As we made our way around Ilzabard, we saw that much of the continent was in various stages of chaos.
Whee!
A certain amount of disorder is to be expected. The final days are over, and the people no longer have a common threat binding them together.
So they fighting.
That's the thing with these fledgling troubles, eh? You need to keep an eye out, lest they mature into full-grown headaches. So, for what reason have so many esteemed personages seen fit to gather?
We hunt and treasure! Also, orgy.
Beneath the waters of the bounty, you say?
Yeah, baby.
I see you've already stolen party. Away my traveling partner with the promise of unexplored ruins and scholarly glory.
Nay, I mean,
it is not for mine own indulgence, but rather the fulfillment of my commitment to the Loperates.
Sure, blame it on the rabbits.
Of course. And if you have Astinian rounding out your group, you'll likely have all the members you need.
I need your member.
Feeling left out? I could put in a good word for you, if you like.
I could put in something else, if you like.
We may have been released from our obligations, but I'll never be free of that merciless wit of yours, will I? In all seriousness, it is best I sit this one out. Too many former scions consorting with one another might be seen as a cause for concern in certain quarters.
Oh.
I'll return to my usual reconnaissance and scout out the situation in the Far East. Feel free to share if you come across any interesting revelations.
I had an interesting revelation in my pants.
Till we meet again.
Damn it, no! Thancred, you're my favorite tank. Please
Shall
don't go.
Hasten our departure. Sir Astinian will wonder what hath become of us.
Damn it. Alright, yeah, let's go see Elf Boyfriend. Let's go check in with Daddy Astinian. So I have to go back to Akiali. Do, 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 do. Hello, Daddy. I sent you to recruit Graha, and you returned with an entire survey party. I hope Matsya's boat is sturdy enough to carry us all. What he means is we are grateful for the use of one of your precious fishing vessels. I'm more than glad for the chance to provide it. I only ask that you take care to steer clear of the reefs in the shallows. We'll keep an eye out.
I feel like reading right now.
Okay. Quest accepted! Oh god. Okay. Okay. Oh man! I have to decide between Stola and Astinian.
Right then.
Yes. Yes. I have chosen. Alright, here we go! BV! I'm gonna fail miserably at being a Dragoon because I haven't played Dragoon in a serious way in a while! Ooh, the music is kind of slapping. Oh, there's monkeys. Ba-ba-da. Thrust and claw and thrust. Okay. Graha, you take a lot of damage. I'm suspicious of this. Thank you. Mara, honey, I need you to move. Thank you. I don't like that. Oh, no. All right. We're gonna focus fire on this motherfucker. I technically don't have to do anything else because Astinian will handle most of it. I keep getting a cat in my way. No! Yay.
Make ready.
Oh, I'll make ready for you, baby. Is that a little much? Oh, it's a looks like a jellyfish. This looks like a jelly. But I think it's not. Graha, go. Go, Graha. Okay, I don't like that. Heal me. This is scary. I'm scared.
Underestimate.
Oh god, Hiccup, please move. Please keep moving. Thank you. Oh my god. No, this is gonna hurt. Hiccup, I need you to move your ass. Please. Hiccup, please move! Oh, yes, baby. Oh my god. My cat is just knocking shit everywhere. Over. Did you knock over? What did you knock over? I have no idea what the cat knocked over. Okay. Moving right along. La 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 la. Jellyfish averted. Salt encrusted teleporter. Boing. Okay. Glyph of passage detected, confirming bearer's identity. That's a big shark. Look, we're deep under the bounty. Our map was no fake after all. Well. Ow.
Together we shall overcome this.
Aw, you're so sweet. Numbers go up, numbers go brrrr. Oh dear. I got a bracelet of casting, which is useless for me!
Together we shall overcome
what?
This.
Okay, I'm starting to get a little nervous about this buildup of shit. There's just There's a lot of stuff here. And, well, okay then. Onward. So, I want to talk about Balma. And how some nightclub guild, or some nightclub FC, thought it would be a great idea to buy a billboard, a fucking honest to God billboard, to advertise their RP night. I am ashamed and annoyed, but also not surprised, because Balmung is, when I say Balmung is cringe, I mean it is cringe. I was part of several sex worker FCs on Balmung, and oh my god. The fact that someone has the audacity to spend real cash on a billboard for a single night, not just like an every night. Well, okay, so that's because everybody knows that Balmung is the cringe place for like hot cyber sex. And that's, you know, not necessarily true, but also kind of true. It doesn't actually do anything to stop people. You can run right through people, but, the sentiment is there. Oh, fuck me. Sorry, Estinian just growled in my ear, and that was, I'm distracted now. Okay, moving on. Oh, this is an interesting Magitek boss. This is going to suck. Boing! Oh no. There's gotta be something with these tiles. Shit! Okay. I don't know any of the mechanics here. I'm just gung-ho-ing. Gung-ho. So I was in the right spot.
Something special for you.
Oh. Diffusion ray. Oh, that's just fuck everybody. Okay. articulated thingy. Articulated bits. Okay. Oh no, what? Ow! Rionje, heal me. I don't like this. I'm gonna just stare. I'm gonna stick with Astinian. Wherever he goes, I go. Oh, no, 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 no! Oh! Okay. Well, that was fun. Oops! I stood in the bed. Alright, I'm gonna try and get this next time. I'm gonna try and get it this time. That was a giant shark. Land shark. Did I get anything good? Oh. No. I am at level... I'm at 580. This place is dropping 575 here. I should not be having such a struggle. Oh, the struggle bus. Alright, I'm gonna stick with Astinian. Oh yeah, baby. Hit them with a limit break right now. Oh my gosh. Okay. Fusion rays, fuck everybody.
This will hurt.
Oh, fuck. That was so hot. I'm sorry, that was hot.
Be gone!
Oh. I'm getting distracted. Give me the echo! I sprinted at the wrong time. Damn it! That was a good line to growl, I'm telling you, man. That distracted the shit out of me. I was like, excuse me? Just the second boss. Nope. He's like, what if I did a dancer? Well, I did not anticipate you guys watching me fail so much, but at least it's amusing. Fusion rays fuck everybody, but I'm not going to.
Hold still.
Oh, baby. Okay. Okay. I don't like you. Astinian, you are really pushing it. That's a tank buster.
Be gone. Be gone.
Oh shit! Oh shit! That fucking... What? Damn it! Did I do it? I did it. Nice.
I did it.
I think I did it. I did it! Yes! I died while doing it, but I fucking did it. Alright. Moving right along. I'm gonna finish this and then maybe do some Beast Tribe dailies or something.
Make ready!
Oh, I'll make ready for you, baby. Excuse me! Oh my gosh. So for those of you who don't know, Sacramento is playing some Saturday night on Discord at 8 Pacific. Be there or be square if you want to play some Cam Vampire. Have fun with that. I play the Harpy there. So always nice.
Hold still.
Oh, I'll hold still for you, baby.
Hold still.
I'm doing it. Holding still. Oh God, a mimic! Mimics! Oh God! Fuck! I don't like mimics! Okay, that's a lie. I love mimics. I hate when they attack me, though. Like, I like the, there's been, like, some modern posts about mimics and the idea that, like, a mimic now would pose as like an Amazon box. And that's just funny to me.
This will hurt.
Oh, fuck. Estinian, I'm gonna need you to like hold off on growling that when I'm in the middle of a rotation, please. Ugh! Uncool! Oh, I lied. It's very cool, but... Jesus.
Hmm. still.
Uh-oh. Cutscene! What's this? Well, dang, where Astinian is. Oh my god. Okay, I don't like that. Okay, that was... I don't want to be around that.
Me.
Oh, I need to stop doing that. Damn it! This is terrible. Oh, I'm gonna die. 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 All right. Ah! Alright.
Allow me. Hold still.
No! Stop!
Oi!
Alright, I didn't die that time. Shitballs! Someone heal me! Come on, bitch. Estinian. Yes, baby! Okay, got that done. Jesus Christ. Casting chest? Well, okay.
What have we here?
'Tis not unlike a Hunnish alchemical furnace in design.
Well, there is one way we might find out.
Go stick us something in it.
Stick us something.
Stop! You mustn't touch it.
Why, Vritra?
Vritra! Oh, my apologies. Should I continue calling you Varshan?
You may address me as you wish. My nature is no longer a secret. Still, this is not a setting I imagined for our union. Surely you've not entered these ruins as common looters.
Would that we could deny your accusations, but I fear you're not far from the truth.
Great Vritra, might we beseech thee to explain the nature of this strange contrivance? It was crafted by our alchemists at my behest, for the purpose of sealing something away.
I wasn't gonna touch it, but you know you stole it. Sealing away what?
Perhaps I should simply show you.
Sure. What's this?
I have lifted the seal, if only for the moment, by an authority only I possess.
Okay, that's fine. Can I have it now?
Plainer Fisher?
No, my friend. Small though it may be, this is a functioning gate into the void.
All right, let's go void hopping. You're not the only one who'd let Yashtola touch it. Can such a tiny portal truly be so dangerous? Says every gay man ever. Void gates and fissures are much the same thing in practice, in the sense that they both allow passage between the source and the 13th. The difference in terminology refers to the circumstances of their creation. A fissure is an incidental tear, whereas a void gate is the product of deliberate action. Suspect this is the latter, judging by the elaborate mechanism put in place to control it. Priceless discovery. Swirling emptiness, it puts me in mind of old friends, not to mention old foes. Yeah. Doing the MSQ until there's no more MSQ to do. Well.
I must admit, I am deathly curious to know how a void gate came to be hidden in the depths of these ruins.
To tell that tale,
We must first peer far to the south, and even further into memory. An age 5 millennia passed when the Algan Empire sent an invading force to the shores of Meracidia. The southern people rallied around the commanding figures of Bahamut and Tiamat and fought fiercely to repel the would-be conquerors. With Bahamut's defeat, however, the tide turned against them. Desperate to seize any advantage, the Meracidians resorted to summoning primal entities.
Yeah, but I can beat them, it's fine.
In response, Emperor Zande forged a covenant with the Cloud of Darkness, sovereign among the all-devouring denizens of the Void.
I beat that too.
Thus bolstered by icons on one side and Void Scent on the other, the two armies clashed in a battle of unspeakable carnage. So much death. So much loss.
I consider myself well-versed in that period of history, yet you speak as one who witnessed it happen.
Well, duh, Vritra's eternal.
Indeed, I did. I heard Tiamat's roar of defiance and sped toward that war-torn land. Along with my sibling, Ashdaya. We dragons are not male or female, as men are wont to classify, but elder sister is the closest a mortal tongue can come to describing what she meant to me.
Non-binary dragons.
I was the last of our brood to hatch, and Ashdaya cared for me where my sire could not. Thus, I was with her when Tiamat roared. I was with her when she journeyed south, and I was with her when she fought against the Void Sent hordes. Yet no matter how many of their vile fiends we cast down, more rose from the abyss to take their place. Faced with an unwinnable war of attrition, Ashdaya risked her all on a final gamble. She plunged through the Void Gate itself to strike at the root of their strength. I tried to follow in her wake, determined to lend what aid I could. But even as I came upon Alag's glittering tower, I saw the rift close behind her. And Ashdaya has been lost to us ever since.
I find I must retract my earlier claim of historical knowledge. Nowhere in the Crystal Tower's archives did I see mention of such noble sacrifice.
That does not surprise me. To Alagan eyes, it must have seemed as if a lone dragon, driven to madness, simply dove through the gate and did not return. For my part, I spent long years searching for the means to reunite with Ashdaya. Until I could search no more, until Alag was dust. And the art to open a void gate large enough to accommodate a dragon forever lost.
Yet you have the beginnings of a gate right here, under the control of a harnessed device.
My discovery came before Razatan was founded. Though I scoured the lands for a method to cross the rift, it was beneath the sea that I chanced to find a natural planar fissure. It was, however, far too narrow to admit a worm's bulk. Only after our city rose upon the rock, and I could enlist the aid of our talented alchemists, did matters take a favorable turn. Their dedication was beyond reproach. Tirelessly, they worked to expand the fissure, and after decades of toil, it finally grew to a size that a child might pass through.
Vritra, you naughty monkey.
Not long ago, you told us that you called out to your kin, but Ashdaya's answer was silence. I suspect the conclusion to your tale is not a joyful one.
With hope in my heart, I used a simulacrum to cross the threshold. But no, I did not find her. What I found was a host of void scent clamoring around the opening they had sensed. 'Twas but a moment, but enough. I had no choice but to retreat and allow the portal to contract once more.
The gate was a threat to your people. You had to decide between endangering Razatarn and abandoning your sister. And you chose the latter.
T'was not that thy sibling scorned thy call. T'was that she was trapped beyond a barrier through which neither roar nor dragon may pass. Even now, in the desolate world of the 13th.
I can scarce imagine your pain, yet it was wise not to linger in that place. Too long a sojourn, and even a being of your power risks being warped into a creature of the void. You've seen this phenomenon before, when we stepped into the darkness.
I remember when Nero turned purple.
As did I. Were it not for Une and Doga, or Nero for that matter, we might never have made it home. Do you remember what happened to Nero? How his wounds allowed the void's corruption to enter his body and twist his ether? Had it been allowed to progress much longer, I presume he would have been fully transformed.
So the void is penetrating.
Then there is little hope for Ashdaya.
Ah, no. I hadn't meant to. I speak only of possibilities. The scales of the first brood are extraordinarily resistant to ethereal fluctuations. They are the protective talisman's core components, after all, and even the corruption I described would struggle to overcome.
Graha, you put your foot in your mouth again.
Of course. With the warding scale in one's possession, one could conceivably survive a stay in the 13th without being warped by its energies.
Be that as it may, it is too late to rescue my sister. 5,000 years too late.
It is kind of late.
And now countless others look to me for guidance and protection. So when I sensed intruders in the ruins, I came only to ensure that the gate remained closed. That, and to secure the treasure, of course.
Yes, she did, buddy.
I wish only to forget the rest.
Well, so they managed to not only expand the fissure, but also manipulate it as one might a gate. Stola. Astonishing. Is there any chance I could look at more of how this feat was accomplished? I'll tell you what I can. First, however, I must return to the High Crucible and arrange to replace the guardians you so handily destroyed. It will not do to leave the gate undefended. My apologies. We were perhaps a touch zealous in our rush to uncover the vault's secrets. If the constructs can be repaired, we would be happy to offer our assistance. That won't be necessary. Much as I retain spare vessels for myself, we keep duplicate guardians on hand for such eventualities. In any case, we should return to Razapan. What? What? Well, that's handy. I'm gonna be lazy. No, I'm not. It's just a quick run. Just a hop, skip, and a jump. I promise we will discuss the Void Gate further, but first I must attend to the matters of the Vault Sentinels. Please bring a new one out of storage and see that it's conveyed to this post. Actually, it was us. Everybody looking all guilty and shit. Why such guilty faces? Surely it isn't you who are responsible for the... Oh. Well, the details aren't important. I'll see it done immediately. Oops. Oops, we accidentally'd. I believe you had questions? Quite a few, but I'd like to begin with the gate itself. Is it still functional? Which is why I saw it sealed in that. It is? So. Okay. Such power must not fall into the wrong hands. That little door you speak of leads to an abyss teeming with unspeakable horrors. That said, in its current state, we would admit only the lowliest to Void Scent, and from this side, no man would be able to pass through. No man? I should think Elfino would fit, given a firm enough push. Physical size is only one consideration. The true restriction hinges on the etheric density of the soul in transit. And yet you succeeded in expanding this diminutive portal to and sending your simulacrum to the 13th. Thanks to my brilliant alchemists, I should have destroyed the anomaly when I found it. But instead I bade them devise a means to control it. After much experimentation, they accomplished the impossible. A method was conceived by which magics could manipulate the fissure and transform it into a serviceable gate. But the process has long since been forgotten. Once I had given up searching for Ajdaya, there was no need to preserve such esoteric and egregious and dangerous knowledge. Thus, the gate lain dormant for years uncounted. Our own passage to the 13th was made relatively simple, thanks to the Crystal Tower, an ancient mechanism channeled by the tower's vast stores of energy to open a void gate, one bound to a covenant made with the Cloud of Darkness. Once that sovereign entity was beaten back, however, the covenant was broken, and the doorway severed from its connection to the void. Theoretically, it should be possible to reconnect the gate by forging a new pact with another void sent, but such deals usually end in betrayal and death. In any case, we should attempt to gain an understanding of the bounty gate. Mayhap you can resume the search for your sister. As I have already explained, I put those futile hopes to rest centuries ago. My place and my duty is here now. I had meant to ask, what prompted you to search for the vault in the first place? I'm blaming Astinian. It was all Astinian's idea. As I recall, it was you who was chasing tales of the undersea ruins. As you have seen, the fabulous wealth from stories is quite real, if not its rumored origin. But I'm afraid I must assert a prior claim. I have been adding to that trove for years, little by little, but the time has come to spend it, and that I might alleviate my people's suffering. Then we are of one mind. We had no intention of taking it for ourselves. Isn't that right, my friend? Of course. Your Excellency, would you object if I were to conduct a closer examination of the gate? I will make no attempt to open it, of course. I owe you and yours a debt that can never be repaid. Whatever boon you ask of me, you shall have it. Ah, you are most gracious. I shall take full advantage of your permission. Would that I could join thee in my study, but the Loperates will be anxious to receive my report. I beg my leave of you. I must be off to Charlayan as well. Cancels order for houseboat filled with hot servants. Yeah, beach. He growled in my ear and I couldn't think straight. We can discuss my findings once I return. You'll not be rid of me so easily. I don't regret breaking the constructs. They hurt me. Meanwhile, elsewhere. Meanwhile, at the Legion of Doom. Guys, I don't like this. Excuse me. Who are you? Sharing the wealth. Speak with Matsya. Okay. I don't know. Let's go to Yedlamod. Okay, where am I going? I'm going over here. Finish with the boat then. Yep. What do you need? Kalzal's loss hit us the hardest. Been trying to find buyers for my fish, and although I sell a few here and there, it's so much more difficult than it was before. Everyone's still struggling to rebuild their lives. For now, we're just banding together as best we can. The Junkmonger. Buddy, you're making it difficult for me to work. Work. How fares the port? Well, it's in shambles, isn't it? Trade routes are open once more now, and the danger is past, certainly. But no small number of merchants have had to sell their ships to make ends meet in the short term. And add to that the sailors we lost in the final days, and it's little wonder the flow of exports is no more than a pitiful trickle. If Kalzal and his consortium were still with us, I'm sure he'd have found a way to turn our fortunes around. Now that was a man who got things done. Rest his soul. Oh, I could have done an etherite shred. Oh well. Here we go. My advisors return. I just made it back myself. We should first address the lack of ships and shortage of able-bodied sailors in Yedlamad. I'm reminded of a child I spied as I made my way back to the palace. His father lost at sea when the beasts sunk their vessel. So many variations on the same tragic tale, repeated over and over. So many lives lost. Enough grief to drown in if we let ourselves be overcome, but we will not. I will consider the perspectives you've brought me and devise a plan to help my people confront this adversity. I would like you to be in attendance when I announce the proposal to my functionaries.
Solomon Grundy, want pants too!
capitalism.
None were spared the tragedy of the final days. Of this, I am well aware.
You didn't like the way he said vigor?
And what of the children who were left without family to care for them?
Hello there.
Hello, HK.
It is a concern which weigheth heavily upon my mind. A simple gift of coin will soon be exhausted, leaving these young souls adrift on the fringes of our society. Nay, a proper solution. One which doth guarantee their welfare for years to come.
How's it going?
Thou hast surely seen how other nations rise to meet this challenge, adventurer. What dost thou deem the wisest course?
Oh, shit. Not too bad. Good.
Of course, the revival of trade can contribute to the building of a new institution. Let us put this idea into practice. A contract shall be written requiring all who receive of ours a Dahl's treasure to commit a portion of their future.
Tax them.
No, such an influential policy is deserving of a worthy name.
That's your concern? Why not honor one of your most successful merchants? Because fuck Calzal, I didn't like him.
A successful merchant. I believe I see thy reasoning.
Call it Dragonomics.
Should be remembered, not as the blasphemy which terrorized Thavnir, but as a hard-working and generous man. Who brought much wealth to our shores. Do any among you object to this proposition? Many here lost loved ones to the beasts.
In that time of strife, any one of us could have broken. Any one of us may have been taken by despair. When I think of Calzal, I feel no hatred. Only a stinging regret that we could not save him as well. Isn't that right, men?
This bodes well for that boy. Narad was it? Perhaps he can cut ties with that shady peddler.
Then let it be done. Henceforth. This initiative shall be known as the Calzal Foundation. Nabdeen, thou art to assemble a patrol and ensure that no child in this city liveth in squalor.
No child left behind! The Calzone Foundation.
Class.
Yes.
See to the management of our funds and make haste. Our citizens must not suffer a day more than is necessary.
Dragon and man, side by side in pursuit of a brighter morrow.
Well, that was cute. Take the silver piece. Okay. I think on that note, I think that's gonna do it for me. I'm gonna keep going with the MSQ probably on my own because I can't help myself. But I got some shit to do and I gotta go eat. So thank you guys for joining me. I'll be back on Tuesday, and then come August, if you're not subscribed to my Patreon to on the right tier. Oh, and you're gonna miss out on my hump day, sim smut. Anyway, I'll talk to you guys later. Bye!